RX channel start broadcasting.
You did it, Jerry. Zaroff used his magic against you and lost.
I didn't mean to do it. Not like this. Marquis, are you...
He's still too weak. He cannot answer you.
Who's the boy? Where did he come from?
The tree. It remembers. It remembers the teacher and the apprentice who once visited this place. Zaroff did evil things. That's why he cannot look the child he once was in the eye. But who among us could, after all?
Who is he? What does all this mean?
The great Zaroff. One of the greatest illusionists of his time. You may have heard of him. Not many remember him now. In reality, he wasn't just an illusionist. He was one of us, a magician. Zaroff was the last apprentice of the Marquis de Hoto. When the rabbit trained him, he was just a boy, not much older than you. When his training was finished, young Zaroff and his teacher visited the clearing of the first tree, and they left some traces behind. The tree would remember them. Soon, the Marquis and Zaroff became living legends as they hurried from one world to the next, from portal to portal, and helped wherever help was needed. They were true tree walkers. But their path led them to a place where darkness ingrained upon their souls. I was there when the Mirror of Shadows disclosed to them their own potential. They beheld their own brightest virtues and saw the darkest chasms within their souls. And only few can bear that kind of truth. So it was only a matter of time until the dark seed sprouted within them. And when it did, the Marquis was the first to start doubting the ideals of the tree walkers. Then the apprentice started doubting the teacher. And finally, the two of them turned on each other in hatred. In his blind wrath, the Marquis banished his apprentice to the world from whence he came. He took away his ability to walk between worlds, so that every portal would remain closed to him. So Zaroff became a prisoner in his own world. A world that had room for magic only on its stages. Thus he became the Great Zaroff, the Illusionist. But the appeal of the new tricks he invented to captivate his audience soon wore off. And Zaroff fell for a second time. Marooned. Forgotten. In his despair, he began to rattle the doors of his reality. He turned to alchemy, forbidden experiments, to open up the portal worlds once again. And with every failed experiment grew the hatred for his teacher and for his audience that no longer cared for him. And when Zaroff was finally driven by nothing other than fury and revenge, something answered to his rattling and knocking. Consortium Squamata, the lizards. With its false promises, the Consortium had already passed through many worlds. Promises that would disturb the balance of nature. Zaroff was approached by four members of the Consortium. They offered the magician a deal. The lizards had surreptitiously obtained the ability to walk between worlds, but they didn't know the way to the most secret of places. Zaroff, on the other hand, had memorized the paths of the tree walkers, the portals, the path to the clearing of the first tree. Thus, he led the lizards through the portals, betraying the tree walker he had once been with every step of the way. In exchange, they gave him the power to cast a curse on one of the first trees. The lizards gave Zaroff four nails. Four nails made of four cursed metals, serving to drive the magician's spell deep into the trunk of the first tree, where it would take effect and make the inhabitants of the portal worlds his final audience, thus trying to obtain respect and glory by force. Zaroff's final great triumph. And while the portal worlds were suffering from the curse of Zaroff, the lizards invaded them, as they had done many times before. Only one could have provided help. But Zaroff's mentor, the Marquis de Hoto, had spiraled himself further into the darkness that the Mirror of Shadows had revealed to him.
The Cold One!
He was willing to let us freeze to death.
The good tree walker who had trained Zaroff. I had already given up hope I would ever meet him again. But when Zaroff entered the clearing, the first tree remembered the magicians. When it recognized the threat that the apprentice posed, the first tree brought to life and sent out the memory of his teacher. So, the memory of the Marquis de Hoto, shaped long before his own corruption set in, left the clearing of the first tree and promptly forgot that it was nothing but a memory. And once again, he was a true tree walker. He set forth to find himself an apprentice, somebody who would be able to stop Zaroff. He answered your call. The roots of the first tree run deep, even into our dreams. The Marquis found you, Jerry, because you had a dream. This place might be his only salvation. He will remain in the shadow of the first tree. The Marquis, the first tree, they were right. You went beyond yourself. That's how you finally got to this place and faced down Zaroff. The Marquis made you a true tree walker, but you were forced to pay a high price. When the Marquis went from idea to reality by entering your world, something else had to go. Your father, as though through a revolving door, the Marquis came to life, and your father was lost in the rift between worlds and forgotten. But do not worry. You saved us all, and very soon we will return the favor. An acquaintance of mine once said, "Only those who get on the way can find their way." And so it came to pass that Jerry had to leave his mentor behind in the clearing of the first tree. Jerry knew that he had been more than the memory of a courageous, one-of-a-kind tree walker, more than the first tree of mousewood needing Jerry's help. He had been a friend. Then, for the last time, the Marquis slowly turned and lifted his hand as if to wave goodbye.
I will never forget you,
said Jeremiah Hazelnut.
And I will never forget you,
came the reply from the shadows at the foot of the tree. And the boy knew the Marquis, the tree. He would remember him. When Jerry returned to Mousewood, lost in thought, there was music in the streets, because for the first time in a long while, an apprentice had come to Mousewood to study the art of arts. And for the first time in a long while, the Treetop Festival, the celebration of friendship and courage, was held in honor of an apprentice who had finished his training, in honor of the tree walker, Jeremiah Hazelnut, the rabbit's apprentice.
Yesterday, and I'm
very kind.
Yeah, great. Yeah, good for you.
No. Henry's now. He has to stay away from the cabin now. A few nights ago, he shot
eye you from something.
I love the Treetop Festival. I come here and I have this magic premonition that you will not be the last of them. Greetings to the portals. You can go home now. Are you ready? Come see us when you're...
We put in here, you.
Mr. Spitface, what are you doing?
Well, I heard that in your honor they were holding the treetop. So, now you must tell me good.
And you tell me
good. Oh, you'll come and see me soon.
They are holding the treetop.
Sometimes it's a good gift. This is a great one. All those fancy together.
Jerry, I heard you're about to. A couple of visitors at the shore. I'll have just really profiled. That's all I'm just a couple. Oh, well, then you'll have to.
A typical. Whatever would they do?
Here's our tree walker. No false modesty. You've got a good thing.
Hey, yes, remember?
Yes.
It's good.
with that age and experience on the stick. And now let's hear it. And then just to the sort of prejudice skills with us. And that is
it's amazing. What is I could do? Did I let the sea
dance over me? Oh,
are you ready?
Yes.
And I'm ready.
I was hungry. I feel like I've been on my legs forever.
Me too.
And that's all Jeremiah could say. The fox girl still claims that he cried.
That's so not true.
Thus Jeremiah Hazelnut returned home, and thus ends our story. But with every ending, other stories begin. They are like waves in the ocean, always in motion, spilling over and intertwining. Some stories tell of huge problems we create for others that can barely be solved, even with courage, especially when you're nothing but a tiny mouse. But perhaps someone is going to step up. Then there are scary tales as well, secret, forbidden ones that you can only tell behind closed doors. Are you suddenly cold too?
Who was that boy?
My friend's apprentice. Thank you for helping him. He broke Zaroff's curse.
I underestimated Zaroff, and that boy too. Will you finally free me from this prison, so that I may once again protect the portal worlds? This kind of thing must never happen again.
You know that this is impossible, old friend.